Hi there, Virgo, and welcome back to Star Lourdes Tarot. This is your tarot forecast for the month of August. I went ahead, shuffled the cards, laid them all out in a Celtic cross. See what's going on for Virgo. By the way, happy birthday to any of you celebrating birthdays at the end of August. So, your first card up is Major Arcana, the Fool in the upright position, followed then by the Knight of Swords upright. And next we have the Page of Cups upright, followed then by the Nine of Wands in the upright. And next we have the Nine of Cups upright. And then we have the Page of Wands in the upright, followed then by the Ace of Cups upright. Then we have the Three of Cups in the upright. And next we have the Five of Pentacles upright. And lastly, we have Major Arcana Justice in the upright. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and interpret this read for you guys. First of all, Virgo, for your overall energy, you have that of Major Arcana, the Fool, in the upright position. This could be representing taking a leap of faith, trying something brand new. For some of you, this could be representing a new relationship. For others of you, this could be representing a new hobby, a new adventure, a new career, something that you have never done before. It's a little bit of risky energy, so it could make you nervous, but nervous in a good way. there could be this energy of taking a leap of faith. Maybe you're just trying to do something new this month, Virgo. And what's crossing you is the Knight of Swords in the upright position, very rushed out energy. The Knight of Swords is a court card, so it could be representing a person. If it's representing a person, this is air energy, that of Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, male or female. This person, it could be an air sign sort of rushing in, wanting to make you an offer of some kind. Could be a romantic offer, could be information that you need, or it could be somebody hurrying you along or rushing you about to get paper signed, to get things doing and things moving. This can represent an offer that comes in, a written offer or a verbal offer for if you're selling something, say for example. This could be an offer. This could be an offer of written offer if you're applying for a new job or a new career. This could be an offer of a purchase for some of you, an offer of employment, an offer of anything. It's just a general read, so it's going to be different for all of you. But that energy is very fast moving. Sometimes it comes in very quickly. Rush in, rush, 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 rush about. So maybe somebody's rushing you into taking this leap of faith. In the past position here, we do have the lovely energies of the Page of Cups in the upright position. Page of Cups, this is something that could have, this is your foundation, past energy, could have taken place a couple weeks ago, a couple months ago. Page of Cups is really sweet energy. This could be even a child perhaps approaching you, making you feel really good, kind of making your day. It could be some of you, maybe you have been babysitting or watching your grandchild or your niece or your nephew, and this person could have been incredibly sweet to you. For others of you, this can represent little messages, and that love notes that come to you. Maybe somebody has been having a crush on you, Virgo, and sending you sweet little notes in the past couple weeks. You come out of the month of July and enter into the month of August with the Nine of Wands energy in the upright position. The Nine of Wands is the Wounded Warrior card. This is someone who's a little bit on guard. It could be because of this new stuff. I know that like this rushed out energy is really good, maybe for the air signs and for some signs, but earth signs don't really care to be pushed or rushed, especially if it's into something new. So perhaps for some of you, this is why you're feeling a little bit guarded. You're feeling a little bit on edge because maybe you feel that things are just moving too fast. It could be a person, a romantic interest that's sort of pushing you, and you're like, whoa, I don't know if I'm ready for this. I've already, you know, dealt with so many challenges as of late, and I don't know if I really want to put myself in that position. for others of you. You know, the Nine of Wands is interesting energy because it doesn't mean that he's going to have to fight. It's just strength in reserve. He's there to fight another day if he should have to, but he doesn't necessarily have to. It's just that sort of feeling of being ready for the other shoe to drop kind of energy. And that gives way in the early part of August to the beautiful energies of the Nine of Cups. You get your wish, Virgo. So whatever this wish is, could be a small wish, could be a large wish, but there is an element of something that you've hoped for sort of coming into play in the early part of August. Beautiful energy, the Nine of Cups is. This is where we've been searching for something on the emotional front and is now sort of playing out. For some of you, maybe this is what you were hoping for. It could have been that suitor who comes on the scene and is sending you the love messages, and maybe, you know, this relationship that started out very small is now budding into something big, and that was your hope or your desire. For others of you, you could have just been hoping for, you know, a pay raise or whatever, or to, you know, get together with a group of people, whatever the situation is. Very celebratory energy, the Nine of Cups is. Just don't overdo it, because it can be representing a little bit of excess. And around the middle of the month, we do have the energies of another page here. This time it's the Page of Wands in the upright position. This time it's fire energy, that of Aries, Leo, Sag, Sun, Moon, Arising, male or female. But the Page of Wands is exciting because he brings in messages, and it could be messages that we've been waiting to hear for a long time. And for example, it could be that, yes, you got the job, or it could be that, yes, you got the loan for your business, or yes, you got the loan for your car, or yes, everything is going to be okay, Virgo. Whatever this message is, he can sometimes represent a travel agent as well. Maybe some of you are thinking about taking a trip, and this person is letting you know your itinerary is ready, you're good to go. And for others of you, this could be a parcel or something you've been waiting on for a while, and now it shows up. And this is you internally, how you'll be feeling over the month of August. We do have the Ace of Cups here in the upright position. This is beautiful energy. This is where we're feeling really, you know, good on the emotional front. This can represent a new maybe child coming into the family fold. This can represent where we just feel that pure love. This can represent where we're finally feeling that love of self, and we're starting to look after and take care of number one. And that's the beginning of that new love and emotion, just, you know, the heart opening up. For others of you, this could be representing a budding new relationship that you're feeling. Remember, he was here. Maybe you're feeling the rumblings of that. Maybe this could turn into something really beautiful. And in your people environment, we have the Three of Cups in the upright position. This is really nice, the very celebratory energy. This is about getting together with a group of people. This could be family members getting together. This could be friends getting together. This is in your environment. This can represent an engagement party, a wedding, or something like that. Or just getting together with people that we really love, having a great time. This is a perfect card to have in your environment. There's a lot of cups here, and they're just really beautiful energy. Just saying, Virgo. And in your hopes and fears position, we do have the Five of Pentacles here in the upright position. The Five of Pentacles can point to, especially in a hopes and fears position, this can be that you're fearing perhaps the financial fallout of all of this. Maybe you have a wedding to prepare for, maybe there's several things going on for you, Virgo, and you're just wondering if your finances can sort of, you know, take the hit to all of this, because a lot of these types of things, such as weddings and parties and so forth, can cost a few dollars. So maybe you're a little bit concerned about finances this month, Virgo. For others of you, the Five of Pentacles can represent being left out in the cold, maybe somebody else leaving us out in the cold, or us leaving someone else out in the cold, feeling abandoned. But remember, it's just in the hopes and fears position. It's not necessarily anything that's going to play out in the month. And the last card you have up that concludes the read for you in the month is Major Arcana Justice in the upright position. What a great way to end off the month. Justice is yours, Virgo. This is the Libra card. We do have an air sign here. Maybe some of you are dealing with a Libra this month. But for others of you, the Justice card can just represent perhaps justice is here in a situation maybe that where fairness and balance was lost in a relationship or in a situation playing out at work or in your career or home. However, justice is here, and it's the fairness and balance is being brought into play here. For others of you, this could represent finally maybe closing out a legal situation. Legal documents are finally signed, everything is a go, and you're just moving on with justice here. So that is your reading, Virgo. I hope it helped you. If it did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Bye-bye for now.